Więc jeszcze raz. Passport Bros. Goście, którzy przylatują z Ameryki, czasem z Europy Zachodniej, zwykle z Ameryki, do Polski, do Ukrainy, do Tajlandii, na Filipiny. I liczą na to, że dating pool będzie tam dla nich łaskawszy. Że oczekiwania wobec mężczyzn nie będą tak wygórowane, jak mają feministki na Zachodzie. Że nie mówiąc już o ich amerykańskim paszporcie, że sama ich pensja zrobi na dziewczynach ogromne wrażenie. I na sam ich widok będą chciały rzucić się na kolana, myć im podłogi. Przy okazji jedną ręką przygotowując obiad, a drugą przyjmując poród ich trzeciego syna samodzielnie. Zgadza się, w Polsce mamy silniejszy paszport niż amerykański, ale nie jest to coś, o czym wiedziałby przeciętny Amerykanin, wychowany w przekonaniu, że żyje w najlepszym kraju na świecie. Nie tylko w najlepszym kraju na świecie, ale w zupełnie innym kraju niż jakikolwiek inny. Jakby tak zwany American exceptionalism trzyma się niesamowicie mocno i jest tłuczony im bardziej do głów, myślę, niż nawet nam tutaj w Polsce. Im się tłumaczy od dziecka, że są krainą wolności w dosłowny sposób. W sensie, że oni są dosłownie jedynym krajem wolnym na świecie. W sensie, że mają najwięcej wolności. Żaden inny kraj nie ma takiej konstytucji, która zapewniłaby im taką wolność. Znam, nie znam. Czytałam w internecie. Amerykanów, którzy dopiero w wieku nastoletnim albo dwudziestoletnim dowiadywali się, że w innych krajach też jest demokracja. Bo to jest dla nich takie oczywiste, że Ameryka jest tym jedynym wolnym, tak? Plus wydaje mi się oczywiście, że dolar to jest coś, za co możesz mieć wszystko w innych częściach świata. I generalnie każdy, gdyby tylko mógł, mieszkałby w Stanach. Więc co jest z tymi Polkami, że nie rzucają im się do stóp na sam ich widok? Dowiemy się dzisiaj. Słyszałam o Amerykanach, którzy w ogóle prowadzą całe vlogi z polowania na Polki w Polsce. Jeżeli macie jakieś ciekawe linki, to podsyłajcie. Będę banować za handheld papera oczywiście. A tymczasem ja znalazłam kilka przykładów takich passport bros. Zanurzmy się w to szambo. Dobra, teraz już miałem słychać. Sorry. O, chłopak, dzień dobry. Nie tylko chrupek do nas dołączył, ale nie wiem, czy widzicie, jest też wiewiór. Wszystkie są. Chodźcie bliżej, chłopaki. Macie lepszy widok na bochenek. Więc słuchajcie. Usunięty użytkownik z Reddita pisze: Am I crazy or are things in Europe just as bad as in the US? I użytkownik Wolf Love Eyes odpisuje: I am from Los Angeles, California. During 2017, dating in most of Europe was relatively easy and people seemed to have higher quality standards. I remember getting 50 matches a month in any city. Nie wiem, czy to jest dużo czy mało. Dajcie znać na czacie. The decline began around 2018 after COVID took over. Most dating apps suddenly stopped functioning well and never fully recovered. Chcecie ciszej muzyczkę? Już ciszam. On the surface, they may seem traditional, but observing closely reveals that few adhere to those principles in practice. Czyli zauważamy pierwsze rysy na szkle. Co? Polki nie są konserwatywne. The script is straightforward. She'll invest time, listen to your preferences, and then feign alignment with them. However, the goal is to extract spending from you. Eventually, she'll leave. Pay attention to her actions, friends, and behaviors, such as reckless driving, self-destructive tendencies, dziewczyno, oznaczajcie się, or strained relationships with parents, which may indicate her true nature. Okay. For those seeking only physical intimacy, opportunities abound, especially if you possess wealth or good looks. While I am decent looking, nie wątpię, my financial resources make short-term relationships easily attainable. However, unless you're her ideal partner, marriage is unlikely until she reaches 30 or older. Women often hold on to unrealistic expectations until their late 20s or early 30s. Gościu mówi o nierealistycznych oczekiwaniach w momencie, kiedy dosłownie przeleciał ocean, żeby znaleźć kobietę, która spełniałaby jego oczekiwania. Okej, oraz jego oczekiwania nagle kończą się, kiedy kobieta jest w swoich late 20s. Wtedy nie ma już wobec niej żadnych oczekiwań, ponieważ nie chce w ogóle jej stać. Okej. Okay. Oni są jak ten mem z gościem, który wkłada sobie kij w szprychy roweru, a potem płacze, że się na nim wyjebał. I met dozens of women who said they don't want long-term relationship with me, but will have short-term affair. Which means women have lower standards if are fun and got money, but they still hold out for someone better looking, for marriage. Niesamowite. To zupełnie jak ty. TikTok and Instagram bear responsibility for disseminating the culture prevalent in the United States worldwide. Today you'll encounter similar types of girls in cities like Shanghai or Mumbai. Those who adhere to traditional values tend to reside in smaller cities, often already committed to long-term partners. A to jest bardzo ciekawa obserwacja. Słuchaj, zupełnie jakby rozwój prowadził do emancypacji kobiet. Co za niesamowita zależność, że kobiety, które mają więcej możliwości rozwoju, utrzymania się, nie chcą wchodzić w tego typu związki, których szukasz. Zupełnie jakby typ związku, którego szukasz, wymagał tego, żeby kobieta była w gorszej pozycji od ciebie. I w momencie, kiedy postęp umożliwia jej pozbycie się tej nierównowagi, twoja wizja związku nagle znika. Ciekawe. If they stay in big cities, their social circle is small and less visible to point, it's really hard to break into it. They are not really open to meeting new people from a different country. Znów. Ciekawe dlaczego. Może dlatego, że doskonale wiedzą, na kogo trafią. Na ciebie. Moving to major cities often leads to adopting hookup culture. Men are less influenced because they're less concerned with conformity, a może dlatego, że od początku byli na lepszej pozycji i nic w ich przypadku się nie zmienia. Whereas women tend to conform to their social circles. If her friends engage in casual relationships, she'll likely feel pressure to do the same unless she has strong family ties and self-assurance. Zupełnie tak jakby casual relationships były czymś fun, były jakąś fazą życia, w którą większość młodych ludzi na pewnym etapie chce wejść. bo ma po prostu wiele zalet. Wow. Dajcie mi chwileczkę. Okej, słabo mnie słychać, już się przygłaszam, teraz będzie lepiej. A, chyba ściszałam się ostatnio, jak oglądaliśmy Twilight. Sorry. I ktoś mu odpowiada. Are you surprised that when you go to Eastern Europe, which is quite poor, that many women will be gold diggers? Dating foreigner in poor countries is the best way to gold dig. Then I don't know. I live in Scandinavia. I think the dating culture is healthier here than in the US. Co teraz z tym za głośno? One, formal dates is less of a thing, and if you do go out, you split the tab. Since wages are more equal, there's universal healthcare and free college, women care way less about men's incomes. Ale czy nie o to wam chodzi? Wiecie, czego najbardziej nie rozumiem? Że z jednej strony chcą tradycyjnego małżeństwa, opartego na tym, że facet zarabia, a kobieta zajmuje się domem, ale z drugiej strony nie chcą, żeby kobietę w ogóle interesowało to, ile zarabiają. I jak to ma działać? Nie wiem, czy zdają sobie sprawę z tego, jak olbrzymim poświęceniem jest to, żeby nie mieć własnej finansowej niezależności, żeby być kompletnie zależną od jednego typa finansowo. Jeżeli jesteś kobietą otwartą na taki układ, w którym do końca życia jesteś zależna finansowo od typa, to oczywiste, że będzie to pierwsze, co cię interesuje w typie. Two people with both work at who both work at the grocery store can raise a family together. They don't have to live in poverty. O, to jest śmieszny take, bardzo amerykański. Czyli, że typ jest w sumie wymienia jako coś niezwykłego, że dwójka pracujących na pełen etat ludzi jest w stanie utrzymać rodzinę i nie żyje w biedzie. Mimo, że pracuje, uwaga, w sklepie na kasie. Bo jak wszyscy wiemy, naturalnym jest to, że pewne zawody, zwłaszcza te no, niezbędne dla funkcjonowania społeczeństwa, jak sprzedawcy, nie powinny być wynagradzane na tyle, żeby ktoś był w stanie godnie się utrzymać. Jestem bardzo zdezorientowana, bo widzę, że wszyscy witacie się z Bartkiem na czacie, a ja w ogóle go nie widzę na czacie. Powiedziałabym, że mnie zbanował, ale na moim własnym czacie? Chęć posiadania Tradwave kończy się, jak trzeba wyłożyć 15 zł na kawę. O, teraz cię widzę. Cześć, Bartek. They can have a nice place and okay income. Their kids will go to college, which makes dating more genuine. Women will go for men they click with and are sexually attracted to. They are looking for a provider. They aren't looking for a provider. Most of the women I know make way more than their husbands and nobody cares. Okay, that's nice. 3. Casual sex is common, but is it necessarily a bad thing? Not everyone has casual sex, just depends on what you are into. No właśnie! Dobra, wow, znalazł się ktoś normalny w tym wątku. But women are more sexually liberated, more likely to say what they want in bed, more likely to know what they like and to be in touch with their sexuality, higher levels of sex education, less sexual repression, more good sex, less starfishing. Co to jest starfishing? Nowy klepacz? Dziękuję za suba. Nie wiem, czy chcę wiedzieć, ale w sumie mówcie mi, co to jest starfishing. I'd want a sexually liberated wife if I was looking to marry a woman. The wife having a low libido is 3 times as common a marriage problem in the US as her cheating. Few women cheat. Many women aren't that into sex. To prawda? And then you are on a fast track to a dead bedroom. A partner who's not in touch with their own sexuality and unable to communicate their sexual needs, or a partner who thinks sex is dirty and women who like sex are sluts. Well, they won't enjoy sex much and then sex will die. A woman who is more in touch with her sexuality and who chooses to marry a man for desire and not finances, she's more likely to have a healthy sex life in her marriage. Jezu, przepraszam, że wam czytam coś, co nie jest do wyśmiewania, ale bardzo podoba mi się post typa na Reddicie. Jestem w takim szoku, że ktoś pisze mądre rzeczy na Reddicie, że aż z przyjemnością mi się to czyta. Starfish to rozgwiazda. Dziękuję. Dziękuję za wyjaśnienie. A, że leniwe leżenie i nic nie robienie, że jesteś pillow princess. Okej. Okay. No tak, że starfish, że się rozkłada po prostu. Dobra. Ej, czy pillow princess to jest... wyrażenie, które pochodzi ze środowisk queerowych oryginalnie? Się lesbijki to wymyśliły? Let me know. Mam takie wrażenie. Co też jest moim zdaniem urocze. Wydaje mi się, że używają go kompletnie niepejoratywnie. Most couples split mortgages, expenses and then custody after a divorce. So getting divorced isn't a financial threat for a man. Yep. Tak, to jest lesbijski term. Super. I don't know. My take is that the US is stuck in a halfway place where everyone gets a bad deal. Yes, to dokładnie to. O Boże, to jest to, co ja powtarzam. Kim jesteś? Also, men who are expected both to be the provider and the modern man. You see the benefits of feminism more clearly when you're arrived at a place where financially things are more equal and equality is more an expectation all over the board. Tak. Dokładnie. To jest esencja tego amerykańskiego pikularstwa w, nomen omen, pigułce. Że w kraju, w którym dwie osoby na pełen etat pracując w sklepie albo na więcej niż pełen etat nie są w stanie utrzymać rodziny, nadal kulturowo oczekiwane jest, że to jedna osoba będzie głównie utrzymywać rodzinę. Jak? Skoro oboje nie są w stanie. Następny post od Passport Bro. I don't want to become a Passport Bro, but I think I have to. What should I do? Sprawdźmy, jaki typo ma problem. I don't want to become a Passport Bro, but I feel as if I have no other choice. Most girls in my country are taller than me. The last 8 girls I met were taller than me. Okej, ale wciąż się spotkałeś z nimi? Więc w czym jest problem? W sensie, najwyraźniej nie w tym, że one cię nie chciały. Tylko te ich. They hate my skin color. All they talk about is liking tanned guys. Meanwhile, I'm very white. To się trochę opal. Nie wierzę, żeby to był aż taki problem. Nie wierzę, że jakaś dziewczyna go odrzuciła, bo jest zbyt blady. They seem to be a lot more likely to be obese. I take very good care of my body and don't think I should have to date someone who doesn't. Nie musisz. Kompletnie nikt cię nie zmusza. The average age in my country is 45. I'm 22. Young girls are very few and rare. But in a place like Korea, Thailand, Philippines, etc., most girls are shorter than me by quite a lot. They like my skin color. From my experience dating Asian girls in my country, they're slim. And the average age there is like 24. There's many young girls my age. I have a remote job which would allow me to live anywhere I want, but I don't want to have to move country to get the dating life I want. It's embarrassing to have to do that. I like my country. I don't want to live in a, no offense, the third world country, which isn't good quality of life, has lots of pollution, etc. I don't want to be the only young white guy there. Everyone looks so different to me. Be judged. Feel secluded. Gościu, czego ty chcesz? Dowiedz się najpierw sam od siebie. All I want is a girl. Okej, okay. Najwyraźniej. Who is small? All I want is a girl who's smaller than me. Myślę, że problemem mogą być trochę priorytety, które masz w życiu. Że dosłownie wszystko, czego chcesz, to laska, która jest mniejsza od ciebie. No! Treats me nicely and takes care of their body like I do. They don't even need to be really pretty. Oh my god, dzięki! Or really perfectly slim or anything, just a normal average girl. What am I meant to do? Typie. Zdradzę ci sekret. Większość z nas zmaga się z jednym tylko punktem, którego ty wymagasz. Someone who treats me nicely. Okay? Wszyscy się zmagamy i wszyscy całe życie poszukujemy kogoś who treats us nicely. That's it. Większość z nas właśnie o tym marzy. A ty masz jeszcze, żeby była mniejsza od ciebie i żeby chodziła na siłkę i żeby była bardzo ładna. I musisz po to jechać aż do Filipin. Nie za dobrze. I would suggest you consider spending 3 or so months in, say, Makati in Manila, so you can get a real sense of what it's like to live there. By no means I am saying it's the same as living in a fully developed country, but quality of life is good there and comparable to Western standards. Just maybe more expensive in some regards. Private clinics, Western clothing, imported food, etc. Widzę coś niesamowicie dystopijnego w koncepcie, że mężczyźni z bogatych, rozwiniętych krajów na własne życzenie przeprowadzają się do biedniejszych, mniej rozwiniętych krajów, świadomie rezygnując z części jakości życia, do której są przyzwyczajeni, po to, żeby wrócić do sytuacji, w której kobiety mają gorzej. Ponieważ generalnie, jeżeli społeczeństwo ma w jakiś sposób gorzej, to kobiety mają 2 razy bardziej gorzej, bo od razu stają się zależne z wielu przyczyn od mężczyzn, jakby przez różne mężczyzn przewagi, które po pierwsze ustawiliśmy kulturowo przez setki lat patriarchatu, biologiczne, to, że rodzą dzieci, więc w pewnym biologiczny sposób są zależne od innych ludzi bardziej niż mężczyźni. To od razu, kiedy warunki się pogarszają, to jakby kobietom się pogarsza dużo bardziej. I ty sam świadomie zrezygnuje z części jakości swojego życia tylko po to, żeby znaleźć sobie kobietę, która ma 2 razy gorzej, bo jedyny związek, w jakim jest w stanie funkcjonować, to taki, w którym jest jego przewaga nad kimś. Ale tu przecież chodzi o to, że są małe. Yeah, sure. Also, why not go to Tokyo or Seoul, since you mentioned you do well with Asian girls? I lived 4 years in Tokyo and I would say it tops the Western cities I lived in. O, założę się, że Japonki po prostu czekają, aż przyjedzie jakiś Amerykanin i powie im, że są takie malutkie. It's not embarrassing to go to a better market rather than waste your time and resources on a bad market. It is embarrassing. Słowi przyznaję, że odniosłeś porażkę. I musisz się przeprowadzić do jebanych Filipin, żeby ktoś cię zechciał. Jebanych Filipin nie w sensie, że Filipiny są takie złe, tylko że są tak bardzo daleko od nich. Don't cancel me. w ogóle to, że większość kobiet jest większa, ale nie wszystkie, więc w czym problem? Nie rozumiesz. Reszta go nie chce. Rzucają się na niego te duże kobiety, no, ma chłop problem. On chce sobie spokojnie żyć, a potykają się o niego ciągle większe od niego kobiety. Bro po prostu nigdy nie zaznał uczucia bycia przyszpilonym do ściany przez większą kobietę. Obiecuję raz i zmieni ci się chemia w mózgu. There's a reason it's called the dating market. Regardless of how much people complain, there's perceived values involved that don't care about being politically correct or nice. If you are going to be in a better market where what you have to offer is valued higher than where you are currently, the smart decision is to go to the better market, if possible, rather than stay in a place where your market value is valued lower and what you get in return is of lesser quality. Frugogirl pisze, omg, gdzie jest ten gif? To chyba nie jest gif, chyba wiem, o co ci chodzi. To jest chyba obrazek po prostu, zdjęcie, kadr z pornosa, szczerze mówiąc. Chodzi o tą wysoką rudą laskę i tą malutką brunetkę. Yep. O Boże, zaczynają rozważać przeciętną wysokość kobiet na świecie. Average female height in Germany is 165 cm. Not sure what you mean precisely, but most girls being taller than you, but it's probably fair to guess you're around that high. Exposed. I'm not really sure that the average age of the population is an issue. It's not like you're having success with your own age group, it sounds. Philippines are your best bet. I don't really see how you're going to find a population of women shorter than you in non-third world country, because, my brother, you are third world height! You're a third world height. Jezu, przepraszam, nie umiem tego przeczytać. Więc moje delivery było fatalne, ale jak możesz oczekiwać żony nie z trzeciego świata, skoro masz wzrost trzeciego świata? Ojej, rozpętał wojnę. How tall are you? What do you think? Why do you think it is embarrassing? You should wear it as a badge of honor, having the accessibility and freedom to do so is peak evolution. Roch pisze, ja bym mógł być troszkę wyższy, nie musiałbym mieć drabinki, żeby odgórzać szafki. Mam rozwiązanie. Znajdujesz sobie wyższą dziewczynę, ona cię podnosi, żebyś mógł odkurzyć szafkę na górze. Od razu takie miły pomysł na wspólne spędzanie czasu. Because this sub gets nuked by feminists and cucklings every day who shame passport bros. I don't know what's more sad, the fact that this sub has more haters than supporters, or the fact that haters would actually sub and spew their negativity here on a daily basis. Yeah, no one should feel the only way to meet a woman they like, oh, okay, and likes them is to look in another country. Just the fact it happens show how messed up dating is now. Nikt nie powinien być zmuszony do szukania kobiety, którą polubi i która polubi ich w innym kraju. Zachowują się, jakby to było prawo człowieka. Otóż nie jest. Jest to the highest human pursuit. To jest znalezienie sobie kogoś, kogo się lubi i kto lubi nas. Jakby wszyscy tego szukamy. Tak, i całe życie często. I oni się zachowują, jak poszli po bułki ulubione do sklepu i ich nie było. Tak nie jest. To jest uniwersalny struggle. Okej, okay, Frugo Girl wysłała mi linka. Czy to jest ten gif, który mam zobaczyć? Czy to jest handheld paper? Bo jeśli tak, to miejmy już to z głowy. Oh my god! Czekajcie. Czy to jest Photoshop? What? Ze mną też się coś stało właśnie. To jest takie uczucie, jak widzę taki content, tu się niby nic nie dzieje, tak? Mogę to wam pokazać, nie dostanę bana, ale jest taki content, że jakbym randomowo zobaczyła na przykład wrzucone przez znajomego na Facebooku, byłoby mi strasznie dziwnie. Jak mam na przykład jedną osobę znajomych, która jest trochę półpubliczną osobą w pewnym środowisku. I ta osoba wrzuca często u siebie na Facebooku zdjęcia pięknie umięśnionych kobiet. I wiecie, te zdjęcia są perfekcyjnie niewinne. Ale jest ich strasznie dużo u niego na profilu. Przetykane normalnymi... I to jest na publiku, na ustawieniu publicznym. I to jest przetykane różnymi branżowymi informacjami. Bartek pisze, jak masz z tym problem, to mi osobiście powiedz, Kasia. Miałam zrobić interwencję, ale postanowiłam, że może zrobię to przez streama. Będzie mniej niezręcznie, ale najwyraźniej. Najwyraźniej nie wyszło mniej niezręcznie. Don't feel bad at all for having preferences and wanting a woman that means them and also wants you. Women have a million minimum requirements for men. It's fine to have your own. The height thing is a major one, apparently. Na razie to wy poruszyliście tylko. Every woman I know has ended up with a man taller than them. Prawdopodobnie dlatego, że statystycznie jest to bardziej prawdopodobne. I've been thinking about looking abroad too, but I'm 47 and I think I left it too late. I've had some bad experiences trying to date in my country, UK too. Oczywiście, że 47-letni Brytol poleciał na Filipiny szukać sobie mniejszej żony. Yep. To brzmi jak coś, co się dzieje. Some passport bros stay in the country, they find their women in the... some passport bros stay in the country they find their women in, but some bring them back to their home country. It all depends what life you both want. I'd say finding the right wife is more important than where she is or how, where you end up living. With the right woman on by your side, every problem is surmountable. Oj, oni się... ustawiają znów sami na przegranej pozycji, zakładając, że posiadanie właściwej kobiety automatycznie ustawi ich w życiu, wiecie, na pozycji do wygrania wszystkiego. Wszystko będzie dobrze, jak tylko znajdą tą właściwą kobietę. Jakby nie, mój drogi, your enemies define you, wspaniały username. Your enemies define you, drogi 47-letni Brytyjczyku. Wiem, że służba zdrowia w Wielkiej Brytanii chyba jest trochę droga, droższa pewnie niż u nas, ale wciąż myślę, że warto zamiast paszportu na Filipiny, znaczy biletu na Filipiny, zainwestować w terapię, odkryć swoje pasje, swoją wartość, odkryć, że możesz osiągnąć wszystko to, co chcesz sam, bez kobiety, a wtedy, kiedy będziesz już w tym miejscu, to odkryjesz, że odpowiednia partnerka też już tam będzie, w tym samym miejscu, czekać na ciebie. Następny. How similar is Western Europe to America / Canada? I've been finding posts about these that return very mixed results. Some say they're very similar, others say they're very different. I'm interested in visiting countries like Sweden, Germany, Denmark, Norway, Netherlands, etc. From what I understand, there are some cultural differences among people within these areas. Ej, są jakieś różnice między Szwedami, Niemcami, Norwegami. I hear Eastern European girls are more traditionals, whereas Western Europe is not. So I'm trying to figure out how similar Western Europe is to the US, especially the women there. Depends on what you look like and where in the US you are comparing them to. I find relationships in those countries to be a lot healthier and women to be in better shape. Are they easier than living in a top 2-3 city in the US? No. I found Estonian and Lithuanian women to be more feminine and courteous. I would stop short of calling them approachable. Your best bet in the Eastern Bloc is to build a social network. The majority of Lithuanian girls I met were introduced to me by guys I worked with. Typy z Reddita odkrywają interakcje społeczne. Also, although this horse has been beaten to death, the level of baseline fitness is staggering compared to the US. The vast majority of women are slim, and because that's the norm, I don't think it goes to their head. I can speak for Spain. Feminism is crazy high here. Maybe extra rebound because 50 years ago Spain was ultra practical with Franco? My girlfriend is Eastern European, by the way. Ej, wraca nasz ulubiony 47-letni Brytyjczyk. Your enemies define you. Na pewno ma znowu coś fantastycznego do powiedzenia. Neighboring countries in Europe can be very different culturally. No way. More so than an American state and the state next door. I'm in the UK and I would say our women are almost as bad as the American ones. A powiedz mi, skąd te w Ameryce się tam wzięły oryginalnie? Niesamowite. I certainly wouldn't be looking in Western Europe for a passport pro destination. I don't know much about Eastern Europe, but I have heard they are a bit more traditional, that modern toxic feminism hasn't got its teeth into them as deep. Ale mi przykro, ale niestety. W nas feminizm wgryzł się już strasznie. I will say that I have visited Scandinavian countries in the past and found their women to be approachable and friendly with excellent English skills. Ach, oczywiście, oni chcą, słuchajcie, pojechać do innego kraju, specjalnie po żonę, ale nie mają najmniejszego zamiaru uczyć się jej języka. Po co? Kasia, nagraj o tym film. Myślałam na anglojęzyczny, po tym jak nagram teraz ten na polski, ale jest już trochę filmów na YouTubie o tym, więc nie wiem. Zobaczę. Our women are not as fat as in America. They might have the same mindset, but they can usually fit through a doorway without turning sideways. Your enemies define you. Wyślij zdjęcie. Mr. Xerx, dziękuję za suba. I think we are less fat tolerant in Europe. feminism, secularism, modernity, high cost of living, not suitable as passport location. What do you mean by feminism? Do you mean equality or something else? Hostile attitudes towards men. The push for women to replace wife/mother roles with career and activism. To na pewno feminizm, a nie kapitalizm. The vilification of normal heterosexual courtship as outdated or predatory. Typie, jeśli nie potrafisz... jakby to określić. Zabiegać o kobietę w sposób, którego nie odbiera jako predatory, to jest tylko i wyłącznie skill issue. Zapewniam cię, że jakby romans nie umarł. Da się flirtować, wiem, kontrowersyjna teza. Da się flirtować w sposób inny niż komentowanie nóg twojej młodszej współpracowniczki albo pytanie kasjerki w pracy dwa razy młodszej od ciebie, czy umówiłaby się z tobą na randkę. I always call that stuff toxic feminism. The old feminism was okay by me. Nie, typie, zły próbowałeś po prostu. Serio, mówię ci, zły feminizm próbowałeś. Jest dobry feminizm. My mom was a proper feminist. I'm in the UK and I would say our women are almost as bad as the American ones. I certainly wouldn't be looking in Western Europe for a passport destination. I don't know much about Eastern Europe. From my experience, Western European women are a lot of fun, especially in cities like Dublin, Lisbon, and Barcelona. I like educated women with good jobs, education, and intelligent conversation, so I prefer that. I'm not sure if you're looking to just go to clubs and hoe around, or looking for a wife, but it's all personal preference. I would try to stick to the Mediterranean cities if you're just trying to have fun, as most international people go on vacation there, especially in Sardinia and all those smaller islands. Some guys have a fetish for super thin long torso. So? Eastern European looking women? But I was not that big of a fan when I was in Prague and Budapest. They kind of remind of what Wiggly Cat mean? Of that Wiggly Cat meme? They also speak English at much lower rates than other parts of Europe. Dziewczyny ze wschodniej Europy, czy my jesteśmy jak Wiggly Cat meme? What the hell? Czekajcie, sprawdzę. Sprawdzimy tę tezę. Podobieństwa? O, już, przepraszam. Wracę. A teraz ja. Jak jest? Bardzo wiggly? Tak myślałam, dziękuję. Czym jest Wiggly Cat Meme? No właśnie mieliście przed chwilą zaprezentowane. Just like in America, you get judged harshly by your stats, so if you ain't pretty, you better have a lot of money to make it up. Feminism and obesity will absolutely destroy the dating market in any country. Oh my god, America has extremely high rates of both. Although Western Europe can have feminism, they don't have the obesity problem. The food is healthy and diets are good. People walk a lot or bike to get around and exercise is a natural thing. The majority of the women are very attractive, so entitlement and unrealistic standards isn't as pervasive as the States. This is why it's easier to find a partner in general over here. Czy pokażę kota jeszcze raz? Sprawdzimy może jak bardzo wiggly jest ten drugi, dobra? Obawiam się, że może być mało wiggly. Dziękujemy, wiewiórku, siorki, dziecięmęcie. Dziękujemy za ten performance. Odkładam na miejsce. Bez kitu, kiedy skończą się nierealistyczne standardy wyglądu dla kobiet. Wiggly cat, teraz mam wyglądać jak wiggly cat. Wreszcie znaleźliśmy coś, w co chrupek jest lepszy. Powiem chrupkowi, że tak mówiłeś. Does cold approach work better in other countries? Co to jest cold approach? Czekajcie, muszę sprawdzić. Cold approach meaning. Cold approach is something you use when you're meeting someone you have no social connection with. Unlike a warm approach to friends, you're meeting a complete and total stranger without even the friend of a friend buffer to ease your way. It can be intimidating. Okej, czy po prostu zagadywanie do kogoś, kogo nie znasz. Yes, people are social overseas. Uwielbiam wizję Amerykanów tego, jak wygląda świat zewnętrzny, czyli tak zwany overseas. Jest po prostu jedno overseas i wszyscy zachowują się tam w miarę tak samo. I mostly cold approach. In Peru, now practicing my cold approach. Got catfished by two big girls. Wspaniała historia, bro. In Peru, now practicing my cold approach. Got catfished by two big girls. A lot of girls online are terminally ill? Słucham? Większość kobiet online jest śmiertelnie chora? They are messaging tens, hundreds of different men. Remember that? Yep, I know, not trying to take any of them serious. She was a wiggly cat girl, he was a steady mietek boy. Chore na liżmę! Yes, cold approach definitely works better overseas. Cold approach works best in the Arctic region. Haha, but not really. Went to Peru, cold approach, a beautiful girl at the bar. Married her 6 months later. Best decision I ever made. Oh fuck, chłopaki, jest nadzieja. Only 6 months, that seems a little too soon to marry. I married a Turkish woman after meeting her for 2 weeks via her sister, my coworker. Oh my god. We got married 6 months later after her visa to come to the US was processed. We had a great life together, but it was a mistake to bring her to US as she made friends with American women who filled her head full of American ideas that just ruined our relationship and made her incredibly entitled and arrogant. The car my parents gave her was too old, her ring was too cheap. We needed new furniture for a room we never used because people would think we were poor. Doing anything became more about getting photos for Facebook and Instagram. It was just total shit after she got an American social media. The first year we couldn't really even speak as she spoke zero English and I spoke zero Turkish, but we got along. She took care of me and I took care of her. We divorced in 2020 after 11 years of marriage and are still friends. She still loves me and hasn't moved on or dated anyone. And she didn't ask for alimony. Bro. What the fuck? Koleś. koleś po 6 miesiącach się wziął ślub z laską, którą nie rozmawiali przez rok, bo nie mieli takiej możliwości. Oh my god. I twierdzi, że ich małżeństwo się rozpadło przez amerykańskie social media. Bro! Bro, ty mieszkałeś z obcą osobą po prostu przez kilka lat. A potem dopiero się poznaliście i okazało, że nie bardzo się lubicie. I've been traveling through Europe and dating apps have been near useless if I want to talk to very attractive women. I've been cold approaching in major tourist cities such as Barcelona, Nice, Rome, and have been at least getting dates. 4 dates in 3 weeks of traveling. I'm like 6-7 and not very photogenic, so I think cold approach is my only option. I'll be traveling the rest of Western Europe through the summer and will keep trying to get better with cold approach. A nie ożenił się po 2 tygodniach, a po pół roku wyjechali do USA? Nie, on przez 2 tygodnie spotykał się z tą laską. Ożenił się po 6 miesiącach. We got married 6 months later, after her visa to came to the US was processed. Przez 2 tygodnie spotykał się z nią najpierw tylko przez jej siostrę? Nie rozumiem. Wszystko, co tureckie dziewczyny urodzone po 99 znają, to amerykańskie social media, nierozmawianie i ostre chrupki. Ej, wiecie, kto to był? To był Rafał z Wegaty. To była turecka Agata, która zabrała mu meble, te drogie meble, które kupił do tego pokoju, do którego nikt nie wchodził. Yeah, absolutely. It works great in places like Colombia, Poland, etc. Hardly works in the UK, for sure. O mój Boże, błagam, nie przyjeżdżajcie do Polski myśląc, że możecie zagadywać do mnie w sklepie. Please, please, don't. Nierozmawianie przez rok po małżeństwie, czy to spoiler Adama i Ewy? Okej, okay, Adam i Ewa, cokolwiek by o nich nie mówić. Mówią w tym samym języku przez większość czasu. Powiedzmy. I never even had to approach. Okej, okay, mamy jakiegoś alfę, do którego kobiety się rzucają tutaj. Did they approach you? Yes. Oh, nice. Where did you go? Vietnam, Thailand and briefly Japan. Co się dzieje za oknem? Chyba jest jakaś straszna ulewa. And did you get approached in all three countries? Do you just go to bars? Like, where do you meet them? Met up with some through old... Co to jest old? Others I met while getting food. Girl I dated for a while I met through friend who is married to her stepsister. Just gotta go do stuff. I try to avoid bars because people get drunk and belligerent. Następny. Most foreign don't care about coming to a Western country. Nawet nie, że women, po prostu most foreign. Most foreign, po prostu foreign. Don't care about coming to a Western country. Niesamowite. Okay, I keep seeing this point being brought up. The haters, critics and even those who are genuinely curious keep saying that these foreign women want a green card. I'm telling you that this is a myth. First, most passport bros are moving to foreign countries, and second, most foreign women don't have the desire to move to a foreign country anymore. This used to be true decades ago, but Western countries aren't looked at favorably anymore, like they used to. I'm from the United States. I love my country, but I don't view it as the best place to live on Earth. I say this as a guy who makes between 100-120k. I'm very much open to living abroad and living in a foreign country. Foreign women in 2024 don't give a crap about the United States like they used to. No way. Yeah, most of these traditional women want to stay close to their families.
Moving overseas is a big decision. They most likely don't want to do that if they already have access to a Western man who can facilitate and upgrade in lifestyle. Ay, 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 ay. I lived in a developing nation for 2 years. Ask me anything. I lived in a developing nation for 32 years. I think the ideal goal is for them to secure a fairly wealthy Westerner who will at least live part of the year in her home country and help take care of her family. They are definitely still interested in becoming American, though. They just don't want to abandon their home country entirely. Nope. Yet, on the opposite, know and have known many genuine women who desire love and want better opportunity. For issuance, my significant other's relatives never had a desire to leave the rural part of Latin America, but when had the chance, she didn't even think about it. It was never her dream to come to America, but American music is global. And many people, the little English they may understand, many times come from music they were listening to. Swam? Many displaced people in Latin American nations who are tired of the rampant criminal immunity and more, yet many have no desire to come here, so sometimes mentalities are split in the same families. And why would a foreign man want to marry a Western woman? Upper class mobility. Fast tracking to green card is primary reason. I know lots of arranged marriages where this occurs. Girl was either born or brought up here. And the parents have matched her with foreign guy that has finished his graduate school for some sort of accomplishment. It's not so common these days, but there were a lot of these. The couples I mentioned are typically of the same background or culture. Once I started traveling and living outside the West, I wasn't interested in living in a Western country anymore either. O, słuchajcie, mamy wywrotowca na grupie. Women are individuals, not a homogeneous group. You have to get to know individual women to know what is important to them. The first woman I dated in Ukraine wanted very much to move to the US. It's an individual thing, not a woman thing. Okay, and my point still stands that this idea that most foreign women want a green card isn't true. Definitely what I've seen as well. Most of these countries also have a major focus on the importance of family, supporting your family members and community. Asking them to leave is largely asking them to sacrifice a part of their identity, a part of who they are. They're not asking you to leave in their country because of wealth or whatever, it's because that's where they have such a huge part of their lives. Oni odkrywają naprawdę basic rzeczy na temat ludzi na Redditie. Truth. My fiancé does not want to come here, but she knows I cannot move to Peru until at least my kids are grown. We must go at least two times per year. She also never wants US citizenship due to tax liabilities being sticky once you obtain the blue passport. Czekaj, czyli on ma narzeczoną w Peru, ale nie chce się do niej wyprowadzić, dopóki jego dzieci nie będą dorosłe. Czyli zakładam, że ma dzieci z inną laską. Ma dzieci z inną laską, teraz ma narzeczoną w Peru i widuje się z nią w ogóle? Truth, my Thai wife absolutely does not want to move to the US. She loves her country and it's not hard to see why. Dalej. Wreszcie wjeżdżamy na temat, który nas najbardziej interesują. Dating a Polish girl. Hi, so I'm not from Poland and currently I hooked up with a gorgeous Polish girl. They all are. Thank you. And it got a little bit more serious recently, which I don't mind, but I've got a bit confused, to be honest. From one side, she wants me 24/7 around her and to be kind of obsessed with her. And on the other hand, she's a bit cold and even rude sometimes, in my opinion. I don't want to reach any conclusion so quick, and I want to give it a try, but this coldness and rude attitude I've noticed even among her friends with their best friends. It's a cultural difference. Bez kitu, Bartek. Typ znalazł sobie zoza i jeszcze narzeka. Oh my god. Typ się urwał prosto z I Love My Polish Heritage. Oni po prostu nie mogą znieść, jak ktoś się nie szczerzy cały czas do nich. Co jest? Ale powiem wam, że miałam trochę ten szok kulturowy, jak byłam po raz pierwszy w Stanach w zeszłym roku. I muszę przyznać, że ich small talk game jest niezrównana. Nic dziwnego, bo w sumie od dziecka są do tego jakby socjalizowani. Ale wchodzisz do windy, no i wchodzisz w Polsce do windy, no to najlepiej sobie nie patrzeć w oczy i za bardzo nie zauważyć, że ktoś jest, ewentualnie skinąć głową, jeżeli to jest ktoś, kto mieszka w tym samym budynku, tak? Powiedzieć dzień dobry. A tam wchodzi do windy zupełnie obcy człowiek i nie to, że zagaduje dzień dobry, ładna pogoda, tylko od razu zaczyna coś opowiadać na temat swojego dnia i to taki w naturalny, serdeczny sposób. To jest skill. To, co oni, jak oni potrafią rozmawiać z obcymi i jak być serdeczni dla nich, to jest skill. I myślałam, że będzie mnie to męczyć. Szczerze mówiąc, mnie nie męczyło, ale też byłam tam 10 dni, więc mogłoby mnie jeszcze zmęczyć. Nie wiem. Było to urocze w jakiś sposób. Jakby na pewno imponowało mi. I nadal imponuje. Nie mogę jak z ludźmi z wydawnictw mailuję. I ciągle się uczę, jak z nimi mailować, bo oni tak pięknie mailują. Tak serdecznie. Mają w sobie... Wymyślają ciągle miłe rzeczy do pisania ci i one nie są generyczne. I wydają się tacy podekscytowani, entuzjastyczni do wszystkiego, co piszą. A ja mam wrażenie, że do nich piszę i brzmię, jakbym im mówiła spierdalaj, więc coś w tym jest. O, ktoś ma rewolucyjny pomysł. Ktoś o pseudonimie Mimcia, więc pewnie wie, o czym mówi. Why don't you talk with her about it? People recently stop talking with each other. How do you want to create relationship without saying anything would bother you? Bez kitu, jak masz zamiar żyć w związku, w którym o swoich problemach rozmawiasz na Reddicie z obcymi ludźmi? Maybe she doesn't know how you feel with this. Mostly being honest and trying to figure it out together can work in many cases. Be kind for everyone is fighting a hard battle. To chyba faktycznie jest o Adamie i Ewie. Ewa walczy wiele bitew. Aha, tu też jest to samo. Dating Polish Girl. O, a tu mamy już... Na YouTubie mam jeszcze kilku gości, którzy rozmawiają o tym, jak wyrywać Polki. Idę sobie dolać coli, bo mi się strasznie chce pić. Zostawiam was z chrupsem. Wiewiór się urwał ze stanowiska. Ale chrup was przypilnuje.
you gotta keep up with Polish women when you're talking, right? You gotta be quick, you gotta be snappy, you gotta have the comebacks.
Boom! Boom! Cześć ludzie! What's up, people? Ora! Vigas that here. Welcome to another episode. Undeniably, one of my favorite things about this YouTube channel is how I get to meet so many of you guys. I get to know you. We interact in the comment section. Sometimes you guys follow me on Instagram and you send me DMs. And I try to be as open and as conversational as possible because I really, truly enjoy that. And this is one of those cases. I met the next gentleman because he commented on my video sometimes, and I don't even know how we ended up here, but today we call ourselves really good buddies, and I think I'm not overstating that. He runs a YouTube channel named Filip Mówi po Polsku. He speaks amazing Polish. He's actually a really good inspiration to me. We get to share a lot of internal notes about Polish women, Polish wives, Polish...
Czemu on je obiad wcześniej ze swoją gitarą? No, a z kim miał? Z polską dziewczyną? Przecież zgodnie z tytułem Polish women are a pain in the ass, but he loves it.
People, so today we're going to talk about 8 reasons why Polish women are a pain in the but also why we love it. Yo, Phil, what's up, man?
Okay. Phil, trochę Chad jumpscare? Oh my god. Hej Filip, opowiedz mi, dlaczego jestem pain in the ass?
Cześć JT. Dzisiaj będziemy rozmawiać po polsku, tak? Bo widziałem, że bardzo dobry znasz język polski.
Oczywiście. Nie. Będziemy mówić angielski tutaj. Dzisiaj, okay. Dobrze?
Po angielsku dzisiaj, tak?
A for effort.
Okay, let's do it.
Before we actually start, today I wanna...
Wygląda jakby miał konto w powerbanku. What?
Remind you guys of something.
Ich trochę głośniej, dobrze. Już daję ich głośniej.
Because it has something to do with Phil. In August, we're gonna have a meetup in Warsaw. I mentioned it on a past episode, but I want to say it again. If you go to Vigo's Dad Facebook, you're going to find
nie.
A private group.
Co? Jezu, widzieliście okładkę tego wydarzenia?
With Phil. In August, we're going to have a meetup in Warsaw. I mentioned it on a past episode.
Meetup? Ile on ma? 36 subów. 36 tysięcy subów. No dobra, może być meetup, ale... O, co się tu dzieje? Ten meetup polega na tym, że siedzą... O, Kitku, wygląda jak Staszek. I walą polskie browary? Bartek pisze, jaj, kto? Słuchaj, napisz. Ktoś się znajdzie.
But I want to say it again. If you go to Vigo's Dad Facebook, you're going to find a private group. In there, I invite you to join because we are organizing a meetup. And Filip Mówi po Polsku is going to be present. He's going to be in Poland. And he's going to be there meeting many of you.
Niesamowite. Słuchaj, będzie w Polsce. Jest szansa zobaczyć Filip Mówi po Polsku. Ja robiące wydarzenie na Facebooku, jak przylatuję do Polski.
What do you say, Phil?
Meeting you for the first time. In person.
Yeah.
That's what...
Kasia, please pójdź na ten meetup, ale to było rok temu zapostowane. Obawiam się, że on się już odbył.
I'm the biggest fan of Vigo's dad. I want to meet JT. That's what I'm all there about.
He's pulling my chain now. Being married to a Polish woman for 10 years, I have a thing or two that I can say. And I've only met one
to on już ma polską babę.
Person that can surpass my knowledge on Polish wives, and is this gentleman right here.
O mój Boże, ale on nas zaleje zaraz wiedzą na temat polskich żon. Jako polska żona mam zamiar ją zweryfikować, ale w sumie czy ja coś mogę wiedzieć o polskich żonach jako polska żona? Chyba trzeba mieć polską żonę, żeby coś wiedzieć o polskich żonach.
He's Polka Pilton.
We are talking all the time on our private group. So I think you are the perfect person for us to do this thing together.
First, I think the first thing we noticed about each other was, hey man, we've experienced a lot of the same things when it comes to our wives. Both of us being married for me over 10 years, you almost 10 years. And there's a very special, unique perspective that we can bring to what it's like to be around Polish women all the time.
Without further ado, let's start with point number one.
So the first thing on the list is their high standards. As we know, Polish people have very high standards when it comes to hospitality. But when you're the one as part of hosting with a Polish woman, you get to experience these high standards, and specifically when it comes to the food. My God, how my wife likes to plan the food is she takes the person at the party who's gonna eat the most. Let's say we have one Pole at the party, he's gonna eat a ton, but there's 11 people there. We need to order 11 times as much as he is going to eat. So it's a pain in the butt because it's expensive, it's a lot of food, it's a lot of planning, but, and it also leads to you eating this food for the next week, but I've never not had a absolutely fantastic party every time we've hosted them at our house.
Man, our wives are going to be so pissed at us because we're just, you know, but you mentioned something that it really resonates.
Jak myślicie, czy naprawdę jest to tak dużo jedzenia i przygotowywania, jak on mówi? Czy po prostu on by kram chipsy wysypał do plastikowej miski? I paluszki i... Let's call it a day.
Resonated with me because you said it gets expensive, right? And no self-respecting Polish woman, and we're talking about wives here because we're married, but this applies to girlfriends. I think this applies to sisters, to your mom. So it's like a Polish women thing, but they will never ever mention or even think about cost of anything when...
Właśnie, Bartek, ty w ogóle rób notatki, to może ci lepiej pójdzie na następnym teście na żonę.
When it comes to their hosting, you know, it's like, you have people coming over, just give them the house. Doesn't matter, you know, they are the guests. Yeah, that's a good point, actually. Panicky is the first point on my list. Whenever I think of a Polish woman, especially when you're in a relationship...
Bartek byłby wspaniałą żoną. Nauka mówi co innego. Badania twierdzą co innego.
Relationship with them is the natural instinct is to panic about things, especially if they don't control them, or if you throw it at them very last minute, they immediately go like, oh no, what is going to happen? I'm not ready. Do you know what I mean?
Uwaga. Mamy unikatową perspektywę. Nie aż tak unikatową. W Polsce może unikatową, bo jesteśmy homofobicznym krajem. Ale mamy polską żonę, która ma polską żonę na czacie. Więc jest to do potęgi pomnożona wiedza o polskożonach. I Kasia Aurea pisze z tym... Że jest tak, że bierzesz... Okej, czy na pewno jesteś polską żoną, bo... Z pisaniem po polsku... Sorry. Że bierzesz pod pachę? Co bierzesz pod pachę? Flaszkę domowego bimbru i wpraszasz się na podwieczorek do sąsiada. Tak. Czasem to tak wygląda. Dobrze, przeczytam dosłownie, jak jest napisane. Mam polską żonę i jestem polska żoną z tym krdzeniem i o jest tak, że bierzesz pit pachę i flaszkę nowego bimbru i wpraszasz się na pit wieczorek do sąsiada. Mniej więcej tak. Tak.
Does it make sense to you?
Yeah, there's definitely, especially like you mentioned, the things that are being thrown at them as a surprise or something like that.
Yeah.
Usually there's the, first it's the anger and then it's the panic, right? That's the next thing that comes in. And even, and I would say this about Polish women and wives in general too, is even if it's not, even if they don't internally feel that panicked,
yeah,
in their voice, in their inflections of what they're saying, it absolutely comes off like they're completely panicked.
Masakra.
Czy ja tak brzmię, jak ciągle wtrącam coś po angielsku? Oh my god!
And it drives me crazy. I'm not gonna lie to you. It drives me crazy because I come from a culture where, you know, you people don't lose their cool so fast, you know, and everything will be fine. There's a solution for everything. Even if we are in the gutter, you know, and we don't know the solution. But I want to say that it is true that they are panicky, but at the same time, there is a silver...
Massacre.
...lining to that. It makes them act fast, you know, and it makes them, I guess, even if they're not prepared.
Zastanawiam się teraz, jak jakby jak najbardziej dosłownie przetłumaczyć bez kitu, ale przypominam sobie właśnie, jak jest kit po angielsku i obawiam się, że mogłabym być trochę za często banowana z social mediów za mówienie w ten sposób.
And they're gonna be mad and they're gonna be whatever. They can kind of like power through that and eventually whatever needs to get done gets done.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it comes from a good place because they want to make sure they're doing the right thing. They're doing right by, you know, if it's a guest that's causing, you know, the issue, they want to do right by the guest and everything like
that. Nie, w sensie, że kit, jeśli dobrze pamiętam, dosłownie, słowo kit, po angielsku, to jest chyba cock?
Like that. So a lot of that panic comes from a good place, and that's the important thing.
Yeah. We have to pay for that good place. But
so.
Czy kak to raczej taki silikon?
The second one, the third thing overall, the second on my list is grooming.
What? Whoa, okay. Smakuje po bagiety. What the hell?
That everybody, Polish women have definitely a way of taking care of themselves, taking care of their clothes.
Ah.
I always like to make the joke. My wife will come to me and say, oh my God, it's the second Sunday in April and it's raining and it's 50 degrees and I don't have shoes to wear in this very specific situation. And it's one thing for my wife to treat herself this way, but she expects everybody else in the house to have those same pair of shoes for that second Sunday in April and everything like that. So. For me, as an American who's used to wearing t-shirt and jeans, it comes off as crazy. I'm like, oh my God, I just want...
Filip, zapewniam cię. Nie różnisz się niczym pod tym względem od przeciętnego polskiego mężczyzny.
I want to wear my one pair of shoes. I just want to wear my t-shirt. I don't want to have a sports jacket for every occasion. I don't want to have a suit for every occasion. But this is what they demand of you. On the plus side, I always look good. As JT, as you correctly pointed out, you've seen pictures of me on my first trip to Poland.
Tragedia po prostu. Tragedia po prostu. Massacre
versus my most recent trip to Poland.
Jaki Polish look, Maxing. Przepraszam, Filip, wyglądasz świetnie.
Was mugging him.
Your comment was, you in your first picture you look like a computer nerd, and on your latest picture you look like a properly dressed human being.
They're very specific about certain things like that, but I think it's good, you know, because at the end of the day, you just have to.
Wygląda, jakby miał zaraz zacząć flipować kawalerkę. Yep, dokładnie.
Just go to Poland, or even not even go to Poland, just meet with any Polish person, especially the women, and that's nothing against my Polish dudes, but the women take care of themselves, they make sure that they are wearing clothes that, you know, looks good on them. I think they dedicate a good amount of time to grooming. And I have the other side of the coin, the flip side, which is, I think Latinas overdo it a little bit too much. It's nice. 60% of the time, and then there's a 40% that you go like, we're just going to the movies, why are you wearing heels? you know? And
bo mam ochotę, spierdalaj.
So
I'm with my Latina sisters here.
At the end of the day, I appreciate that. And I have to say that you say that, but I saw you have a Polish suit that you bought, a blue Polish suit.
A blue Polish suit? Co to znaczy a blue Polish suit? Jest jakiś konkretny Polish suit?
On. And I think you're gonna get some more stuff now that you go. So his Polish wife is doing her job.
She's definitely done her work, because I have to say one of my favorite things now about going to Poland is buying more clothes.
My second thing, or fourth overall, is taking matters into their own hands. If you have a Polish woman in your life, this is one of the things that...
I have a Polish woman in my life. I have a Polish woman in me. I have two Polish women in me, and they're fighting with wolves, with two wolves. One wolf per Polish woman inside me. It's a mess.
At least to me, surprised me the most. They don't have too much patience, so they're like, okay, so what is going on? You get the guy to cut this, you know.
Fighting with kokoszka. O, cieszę się, że pamiętacie lore z poprzednich streamów.
The tree that is falling, if not, I'm gonna go to the store, I'm gonna buy as a...
And they are gay? The wolves or the Polish women? There are two zoos inside you and they're both gay. Są we mnie dwie Polki. Jedna jest zozą, druga jest siksą. I się całują.
Chainsaw and I'm gonna do it, okay? And they're, you know what I mean? They're not bluffing. They will do that.
I have to say, most of the rooms, like we bought a new house last year, and most of the rooms in the house were painted by my wife simply because she got tired of waiting for me to either have time to be able to paint myself or to hire a painter. She's simply like, that's it. I am going to the paint store. I'll be back with paint and I will paint the room.
And man, I mean, I know that sounds like it's really good, and it is good, but at the same time, it's also kind of like a pain in your bum, because it's like, woman, give me a second, you know what I mean? I'll get to that in the weekend. And you see that she's there, I don't have time for that.
Absolutely. I think also one of the side effects that they don't really seem to notice is it's fine for you, it's fine for me. Our wives are very proactive in taking care of things around the house.
Yeah.
But when outsiders come in and see, like I know I've had people coming into the house, you know, contractors or whatever, to go and work on things, and my wife will be like, well, I did this and I did that and I did this other thing, and the contractor just kind of looks at me like, what the hell are you doing? And I'm like, I do.
Oh. To jest jak typowy mąż z sitcomu, co prosisz go, żeby coś zrobił tygodniami, on tego nie robi, ale jak zrobisz to sama, to się zdenerwuje, bo wtedy mu męskość obrażasz. Bo się czuje mniej męski, że... Albo jak, nie wiem, ktoś inny ci pomoże, albo jak wynajmiesz kogoś do pomocy, to jest prosto w jego męskość.
Work around the house as well, it's not just her.
You're there looking like you're a stay-home dad, right. Watching soap operas or something, you know? Polish women, to please stop dupę. Making us dudes look bad.
Oh my god, to przestań sam sprawiać, że wyglądasz źle.
Exactly.
At least us foreigners, you know, because let's face it, Polish dudes are pretty hands-on with things, so we have to give them that.
Our wives might be so impatient because they're used to the similar impatient of Polish men, right? But yeah. You and I think we have a little bit more patience than a typical Pole.
Yeah, so we're like, okay, I'll get to that. My wife, I know, is going to make some comment saying that if it's, she's waiting for me, it's going to be the next year till I do it. But okay, fine, I'll take it.
Yeah, so for my third, whatever they are doing is the most important thing in the house, and everybody needs to fall in line. So similarly, as we were talking previously about doing work around the house, once they get the impatience, they decide they're doing work around the house. Now, yeah. it's a Saturday, they're painting. Therefore, everybody else needs to get in line and take orders about what needs to be done to allow her to paint this house, right?
Nie dość, że typiara sama planuje, sama organizuje, sama decyduje, co jest do zrobienia w domu, sama to wykonuje, to jeszcze oczekuje od niego, że on jej to umożliwi w jakiś sposób. Au, ała, ała!
I need to run to the store, my...
There's no, hold on!
Yeah, I need to run to the store. My daughter needs to, you know, behave for the entire day, sit there patiently. The dog needs to take itself out, you know, for a walk. This is the most important thing in the house right now, is painting.
Tak, malowanie jest... Jak chcesz coś pomalować, to jesteś...
This wall, you know.
Man, I completely agree with you. It becomes the main talk, because I think that Polish women are very good. You know, I think they say for the most part that women are very good at doing many things at the same time.
Multitasking, yeah.
But I think that once they put their eye on a specific target, I feel that they need to finish that task so that they can move on to the next one. But obviously, they have too many things in their mind, so this one needs to be done as fast as possible so that they can move on to the next one.
Exactly.
You know? Whereas us dudes, I think even though we are very like one task oriented, because we're human beings, if we have to deal with many things, we are like, okay, I'm gonna do a little bit of this, then I'm gonna jump to a little bit of that, and then it's like, yeah, I can come back and, you know, finish this task here. But at least my wife, maybe I am, you know, being very subjective, but it's like she says that it feels as if she has a fire.
Zachas, dziękuję za suba. Z wiadomością, Jezu, co to za typy, podłączoną do suba.
Under her ass, because she's like, I need to finish this, you know what I mean? And then we move on to the next.
Right. Usually in my wife's case, it's because she needs to run off to the store, you know, she needs to buy a dress for the next party we're going to, and so she needs to hurry up and paint this wall because the store is going to close at a certain time.
Oh man, Polish women, we love them.
Polish women, we love them. Shut the fuck up!
We love them, seriously. Okay, so my third point is that they are very witty, they're very fast when it comes to how they think. They are very, very, very fast. You know, if you hesitate with a Polish woman, you're gonna be left behind. Basically, you're gonna become a ciepłe kluche, because they are like, listen, the normal state in a relationship with a Polish woman, I think you're gonna agree with me, there's always some banter. There's always a little bit of tension on that rope, you know what I mean? Always.
Absolutely. I think one of the most, you know, as we said before, I'm an engineer. I like to think first and act second, and my wife is the exact opposite as me. So one of the most common conversations we have in our house, everything gets said in both languages, in Polish and in English. And my wife will say something, you know, what do you think about this, in Polish first? And I'm just sitting there simply thinking about it. And then she immediately says it in English. I'm like, I understood what you said. You gave me half a second to think about my answer.
A nie, moja żona dba o to, żebym ją zrozumiał, chociaż w ogóle nie znam jej języka, a ona zna mój, tylko nie to.
There's the rope, you know, the tension in again.
My daughter says to us all the time, you know, why are you guys fighting so much? And we're like, we're not fighting, because I've kind of taken on a lot of, you got to keep up.
Jesteś pewien, Filip? Jesteś pewien that you are not fighting?
With Polish women when you're talking, right? You got to be quick, you got to be snappy, you got to have the comebacks, you know. From an outsider looking in at us, it may look like we're bickering a lot, but there's really no anger in what we're doing at that moment.
Hey Phil, maybe we should at some point write a book, a manual of the best comeback.
Actually, yes, chłopaki, napiszcie. Please, napiszcie tę książkę, błagam was.
With a Polish woman or something. You know what I mean? If this happens, then do this.
The plus side of it is, I would say, I've often read that, like, being able to be quick-witted and sarcasm having sarcasm is a sign of intelligence, and I think we've definitely seen that, Poles in general, but especially, you know, Polish women in general, you know, they're all very intelligent, and it shows. And
wszystkie, absolutnie wszystkie jesteśmy bardzo inteligentne.
They're how quick they are, we're able to think on their feet and everything like that. So the last thing on my list, and I think we're going to have the most fun with this one, because you and I have talked about this a lot. Polish women are loud when they do everything.
Fuck you.
Everything.
Oh, snap.
Okay.
Co to było? Jakiś randomowy shot z Futurami.
It is the end of this episode. That's it. This is the truest of the most
My wife gets up at 5 in the morning. I get up at 6 in the morning. My wife, the first thing she does after she gets downstairs, she makes her coffee, she starts emptying the dishwasher.
At 5 in the morning.
What I'd like to tell you is, at 5 in the morning. What my...
Może gdyby miała świadomość, że ktoś inny zrobi to, kiedy wstanie, nie robiłaby tego, kiedy ty śpisz.
Wife says is she is being very quiet. She's being...
Zauważcie, że mówię to bardzo cicho.
Being very considerate of everybody that's still
yeah,
sleeping.
Right.
My wife empties the dishwasher like she is upset that somebody didn't get up at 4:45 in the morning and empty the dishwasher before her, and now she is forced to sit here and...
Może trzeba było zrobić to wieczorem, zanim poszliście spać.
Empty the dishwasher in her morning.
Oh, don't I know that behavior?
Boże, oni się tak z tego śmieją, jakby to była najzabawniejsza, najbardziej urocza anegdotka na świecie. Założę się, że to, że ona jest tak wkurwiona, jak wstaje o 5 i musi załadować zmywarkę.
I don't know, it feels like nature balanced them out. Because...
Ona z koleżankami opowiada sobie o tym w zupełnie innym tonie niż chłopaki to tutaj przedstawiają.
You know, and I don't mean to sound patronizing or anything like...
Czy oni obaj wyszli za Danusię Norek?
Yeah, but Polish women are very beautiful. And then, to balance it out, they're not gonna make them delicate. They're gonna make them, you know what I mean? Like, whatever a Polish woman is doing, you know that she's doing it.
As I've said, yeah, my catch-all statement for that is all, they do things like they want the entire world to know that they are doing those things.
How, before I was with my wife, I did not know that a person can have such a thing as too heavy of a step. You know what I mean? Like, she's going up a...
O mój Boże, zaraz będzie jeszcze pierdolić, że za głośno tupie mu żona.
Stairs, and I'm like, are you stomping on purpose? I mean, what is... I'm just walking.
O mój Boże, oh my God, wyobraźcie sobie, że wstajecie o 5. Prawdopodobnie, żeby zająć się dziećmi. Pierwsze, co musicie zrobić, to załadować zmywarkę, po czym wasz mąż, który w tym czasie słodko sobie spał, wstaje i mówi wam, że za głośno tupiesz. Pojebie mnie.
Yeah, you know? Boom, boom, boom.
And that's the fact. It's like I said before, like I've said with previous things. It, for me as an American, it comes off like they are very upset at whatever they're doing. They're stomping around the house, right? They're throwing silverware into the drawers, right? They're slamming pots onto the stove. I'm like, what is she so upset about, you know? Nothing. This is just her normal noise level.
And let me tell you, I don't know if it happens with you, but this gets highlighted even more when you have actually been on a fight.
Yeah.
And they're doing anything that already they are loud and you know, like, not that delicate, but it's like that 1% that goes high. It's like you feel that she's about to destroy the house because she's pissed, you know.
You're bringing up delicacy. That's another important point. Like, I feel like, you know, when you have some things in your house that are a little loose, a little broken, you're not quite sure if it's completely broken or not, and you're like playing with it a little bit, you know, I'm sure you and I'm sure me will go, just move it a little bit, just to see. Polish women come up and go, is this thing broken yet? And I'm like, well, it is now. I guess I'm gonna fix it.
Come on, all our dudes here that are in relationship with Polish women, come on, like, right now all of you are probably nodding your head, you know, and your significant Polish others are looking at you like, you know. But if you're gonna be stuck with someone and you have to depend on them to handle things, then I guess you want someone that is gonna be strong, you know, and it's gonna...
If I'm looking for somebody to have my back, there's probably not any much better choices than a Polish woman.
Yeah, for sure.
Czemu się nie śmieję? Nie, ja jestem Polką, mam po prostu taką twarz.
Let's jump into the last.
W środeczku śmieję się bardzo głośno. I bardzo głośno tupię.
The point here, which is stubbornness. And this one is going to be the cause of me getting gray hair or going completely bald. Jesus Christ, does this thing. I know that there's a positive to this, for her maybe, in her life, but Jesus, are they stubborn, dude? Especially if they feel that they're right, there's no, like, it feels almost like you have to...
Feel like they're right. Nie to, że mają rację, tylko...
Proof to them. I don't know. Are you in the same boat? Please tell me you are.
It's like a catch-all. I think we originally made much longer list, and I think this one kind of catches a lot of the things, right? They never think they're wrong. They always have the perfect advice for anything you're doing. They can change their mind, but it takes a high amount of proof to change their mind. I can't tell you how many times I've told my wife something, and then 2 weeks later, she comes to me with some like Instagram story and going, look what this guy's saying. I'm like, I told you that exact same thing 2 weeks ago. Why do you believe him and you don't believe me?
It's a really remarkable thing because I don't know. It's like they are, and this is the part that I say that there's something good out of that because they're not going to take things at face value, right? Like they're going to question, they're going to inquire. And I think that's what they are. They are actually good professionals. Like there are, I think I read, my wife sent it to me, you know, some reports said that Polish employees are usually perform really well. But I think it's because they like to question things. You know, they like to, it's not like just the boss said do this. And that's good for them. But for us as the partners, we have seen, you know, the ugly side of that. And it has cost many arguments between me and my wife because I always say, right. I don't know, maybe I am just a more agreeable person, but I am the type of individual that if you tell me something, I will, well, maybe there's some truth to that. I will look into it or I will think about it. That doesn't mean that I'm gonna do what you're saying, but I'm gonna, right. You know, but no, with a Polish wife or girl, she's not gonna tell you, oh, maybe you have a point. No, they're gonna be not. No, that's not true.
And it comes to the things that, like, it's very obvious there should be multiple ways of viewing things.
Okay,
as we said before, they have higher standards. They expect you to live up to them, right? It's not always the easiest, but it's worth it in the end, right?
It is, man. It is. Boom! That's all, guys. Oh, that's the end of the episode. I hope you liked it. Phil,
God. Thank
you for being the co-host on this episode. Like, there's not a better person that could have thought to share an episode like this than you, because like I said, your level of knowledge on Polish women is...
Ej, wiesz, kto mógłby mieć większą wiedzę na temat Polish women niż Filip? Jakaś Polish woman na przykład.
It's really up there. I think we can wrap this up and I'll see you in Warsaw.
Absolutely,
in around
let's do this.
A month and a half, 2 months.
Mam chłopaka z Ameryki i w sumie pieprzy podobne bzdury. Ja nic nie mówię. Pozdrów go. Pozdrów. Rozładowują mi się moje urocze słuchawki. Moje słuchawki, które swoją drogą najwyraźniej są jednym z głównych źródeł sukcesu mojego na amerykańskim YouTubie. Muszę je podłączyć, podładować. A chodzi konkretnie o jeden komentarz, który wam zaraz przeczytam. Pod moim przedostatnim filmem na YouTubie, na kanale Kasia Baba. This video is proof that all women have to do to blow up on the internet is sit in front of a camera wearing cat ears and be under 20 years old. Bam! 250,000 views. Pierwszy typie. Mam 31. mniej niż 28. Thank you. Podpowiedzcie mi, co możemy zrobić, zanim naładują się słuchawki, bo jak mamy grać w Simsy, to potrzebuję moich kocich uszosłuchawek, bo inaczej nikt tego nie obejrzy.